In this video, I'm going to show you why premade decks are awesome and how you can make the most of it. Hey there, I'm Subhav Ramnani, the guy who's mad about medicine, just like you. If you're new to Anki, then I suggest you to start from the very first video in this playlist, and I'll link it down here and also in the description box below. So we're going to build up on our Anki 101 series, and now we'll jump to the topic of pre-made decks. Spoiler alert, I'll be speaking for the motion. So question 1, what are pre-made decks? So pre-made decks are a set of flashcards which are created by someone else. So this generous person has done all the work of creating the flashcards, and now all you have to do is to study them. Sounds simple, right? So where can I find these pre-made decks? Is this a good deck? Is this deck right for me? We'll be giving answers to all these questions today. Also, since Anki is not a very user-friendly platform, I recommend you to stick with me, because in the end I'm going to summarize everything, and hopefully that will make you understand everything better. Also, I'll be sharing 5 essential tips that you should be following while using pre-made decks. So let's go. So starting with the basics, why do you need a pre-made deck? Number 1, you just don't want to go through the process of creating all the flashcards. Number 2, you're short of time. Or number 3, you just don't have the resources to create a flashcard. Now, pre-made decks can either make or break your study plan for the future. If you don't use them right, you'll be just memorizing random facts and wasting your time. And if you use it right, you're going to benefit from it so much. Now, question 2, where can I find all these pre-made decks? Now, you can find all these pre-made decks on the Anki website itself, but you'll find the most amazing ones on Reddit. I'll put down a link to the subreddit in the description box below. Now, how can I tell if this deck is right for me? How can I tell if this is a good deck? To answer all these questions, let's dive into my screen. Here I am on the Reddit page, which has all the decks. The link is down in the description box below, as I mentioned. Here you can see on the right side are decks for Step 1, Sketchy Medical, Anatomy, Single Subjects and all. Most of the pre-made decks out there on the net are for USMLE exams. Now don't worry if you're not preparing for the USMLE and are still looking for a pre-made deck. You can still use these decks to your benefit. So these Step 1 decks have all the content from your pre-clinical studies like Anatomy, Physiology, Biochem, Path, Pharma, etc. If you click on these decks, they have a very good description of what resources are the flashcards created from, and that is exactly how you want to use them. So from here, you will get the answer to your question about if this deck is good or right for you. So whatever deck you like, you will find the download links for that in these posts. Once downloaded, just open Anki and double click on the file to import the deck in your Anki. Now let me take you to my favorite deck, which I use and I recommend. It's the Anking deck. Here, you click on the deck, it takes you to this screen. Now this banner will tell you everything about the deck. What does it comprise of, who made these flashcards, and who helped in tagging these decks. I am very honored to be a part of this amazing team and help tag a few topics. All credit goes to the Anking team for starting this initiative with creating, compiling and tagging the whole deck, and sincere thank you from my side for the amazing selfless contribution to this medical community. I'll put a link to their website in the description box below, so do check them out. Now let's jump straight into the deck with the browse option. Now you'll need an add-on to see all the topics listed and categorized by the tags like this. It's called the hierarchical tag add-on. So to enable this add-on, all you have to do is to go to Tools, Add-ons, Get Add-ons, and then put this code and click OK. After this, restart your Anki and your add-on should be enabled. Don't worry, I'll put the code down in the description box below along with the link, so you can easily copy paste from there. So let's go back to the browse section now. Once you have the tags like these, you'll see that they are very well organized and that is why so many people use this tech. So now let's talk about the workflow. First thing you want to do is to select all your cards and suspend them. Suspend means you lock these cards for now. To do this, you click on the deck icon which says Anking. You'll see that all the cards in the deck appear on the right. Now you want to select all these cards by pressing the Command plus A on Mac or Control plus A on Windows. Now press Command plus J or Control plus J to suspend them or lock them. Alternatively, you can right click and select the toggle suspend option from the menu. So now, when you go back to the deck screen, it'll show you that you have zero new cards to do. Now let's say you studied heart failure from cardiology. So you will now go to the browse window, find the tag which says AK step 1, and you'll see it has a bunch of tags under it. Now all these terms have a meaning. The tags which are starting from the hashtag symbol are the resources. For example, hashtag BNB means that these tags are according to the videos from Boards and Beyond or BNB, which is a video learning platform for the USMLE, just like PrepLadder or Marrow for the NEET PG. So all these hashtag symbol tags are different resources. So let's open BNB by clicking this arrow and go to cardiology and then find the topic you studied. Example, heart failure. You can see it has even more categorization further, like systolic, diastolic heart failure and all. Once you click on the topic you have studied, you will see the cards from the topic here in the browse window itself. Here, you can read and go through the cards. You can even click the preview button here to see how they look once you unlock or unsuspend them. So let's say all these cards make sense to you. So just select all of them by pressing the Command plus A on Mac or Control plus A on Windows and then unsuspend or unlock them by pressing Command plus J on Mac or Control plus J on Windows. Alternatively, you can right click and select the option which says Toggle Suspend. Now all these cards are unlocked or unsuspended. Once done, close the browse window and now you'll see that on our DEX home screen, we have some new cards to do. This means you have these new flashcards to study. You did not have to make them yourself. They are ready to be learned. So when you click on the deck now, you can start learning from these cards. So this is how you study a topic and then find the relevant flashcards and unsuspend or unlock them. So in summary, what we did was, number one, looked for a deck which would suit us. Number two, added the hierarchical tags add-on so we can see the tags categorized in the browse window. Number three, learned how to suspend or lock all the cards first. Number four, found relevant cards of the topic we studied. Number five, and in the end, we unsuspended or unlocked these cards and made them ready to be learned. Let's talk about the five important tips you should follow while using Premade decks. Number one, do not unlock or unsuspend any card you don't understand. This will just lead to memorization without really understanding the concept behind the information. Number two, most Premade decks have a lot of extra information behind the card. Make sure to go through it because it might be useful for you and also in understanding that card. Number three, if you can't find a card within the categorization, try searching for it in the browse window. Search will give you a lot of results or keyword matches and you can look at each card from here and unsuspend the ones you want. Number four, now don't study the cards right after you unsuspend or unlock them, because this will just lead to memorizing the card because you just read it. Instead, what I do is I unlock the cards and do them the next day. This way I'm actively recalling information from my brain and therefore I'm studying the card better. Number five, if you found this pre-made deck method helpful, then do support the channel by clicking the subscribe button below and also give it a like if you found this video awesome. If you have any questions regarding this topic, then please drop it down in the comment section below. I'll try to answer to all of you. And as always, stay healthy, stay safe, and stay mad, but just about medicine.